dear viewers and dear dear student, welcome to my channel Science and Vigyan. Today I would like to explain brief introduction to redox titration. These titration are very important, so I just give you an idea about these titration. And if you really like to watch these type of videos in the future also, please to subscribe my channel Science and Vigyan. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thank you. Redox titrations. These are the contents of the presentation. First of all, what is a redox? Oxidation, reduction. What are main agents? Titration and the redox titration. And the last is the types of redox titrations. Right. First of all, what is redox? Redox is composed of two words, red and ox. Red mean reduction and ox mean oxidation, right? They made from two words, red plus ox. Red mean reduction, ox mean oxidation. Both occurs simultaneously. One species oxidized and other reduced. Oxidation, the loss of electron from a substance, or gain of oxygen, that is the oxidation, right? Example, when glucose is oxidized to carbon dioxide, that is oxidation, right? Here glucose in the form of energy with the help of oxygen, or we can say that here is a gain of oxygen. And this glucose is converted into carbon dioxide, right? So you can see that here is a 6 molecule of oxygen and here are the 12, right? And there is gain of these 6 oxygen molecule to this glucose to produce carbon dioxide. Or there is a loss of electron, right? In this way, electron will be lost and it will be oxidized, right? Next is reduction. Reduction means that is the opposite to the oxidation. In the oxidation there is a loss of electron, and in the reduction there is a gain of electron, right? Example, chlorine with the help of electron, and here is a gain of this electron to produce chloride ion, right? In this way, A plus B, that give rise to A positive and B negative. This example show oxidation and reduction simultaneously. Here A is converted to A positive, that is there is a loss of electron, it means that process is oxidation. And B is converted to B negative, it means there is a gain of this electron, that it is the reduction, right? Carries a low energy and it carries a high energy, right? Next is what are main agents, like reducing agent and the oxidizing agent. Reducing agent means that loss electron, and oxidizing agent means that gain electron, right? In this way, reducing agent converted to, or reducing agent lose one electron or the two electron to oxidized, and oxidizing agent they gain electron to produce reduced B. These are the reducing agent where there is the loss of electron, and in the oxidizing agent there is a gain of electron, right? Next is the titration. What is the titration? Act of adding standard solution in small quantities to test solution till the reactions on completion, that is of titration. And now one question comes in your mind, that what is the basic difference between the standard solution and the test solution. Standard solution means whose concentration is precisely known, that is a standard solution. And the test solution means whose concentration is to be estimated, that is a test solution. Next is the redox titrations. Redox titrations are based on an oxidation reduction reaction between the analyte and titrate. Reducing or redox titrations are carried out using potentiometer or redox indicator to determine the endpoint. This is example of redox titration. Here titrate is added from the butyl to analyte. Redox indicator is already added to in this analyte, right? And these are all about the types of redox reaction or titration. Basically, redox titration are of two types, direct and indirect. Indirect, we can say that these are back titration. Direct titration. Direct titration is a way to determine the contents of substance quantitatively. And indirect titration is a titration method where the concentration of analyte is determined by reacting it with a known amount of excess reagent. That is all about the indirect or back titration. In this, we just add the known amount of excess reagent, and that excess reagent is allowed to be react with the analyte. This is all about the redox titration. This is all about the brief introduction. You can take the quick review by seeing this video before you watch the results. Thank you so much. If you didn't like to watch this video, please do like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel Science and Vigyan. Thank you.